Good morning, children. Children, our next lesson in EVS 2 is Shivaji's childhood. Children, in the previous lesson, you learned that Shahaji Raje left Adil Shah and joined Nizam Shah again. Because of this, Adil Shah was angry and he burnt down the Jagir of Pune. Shah Jahan from the north had sent a big army to conquer the Deccan. So, Shahaji Raje was in real trouble. At that time, his wife Jijabai was pregnant and he was worried of her safety. Shahaji Raje then remembered the Shivneri fort and decided to send Jijabai there. Now children, you can see here in the picture, that is Shivneri fort on top of the mountain. Shivneri was a strong fort near Junar in Pune district. It had steep cliffs on four sides, strong fortifications and massive doors. So children, you can see surrounding the fort, there are steep cliffs on all the sides. Now children, you can see here the fort in the center and there is a huge wall surrounding the fort. So the fort was very well protected and guarded. Now here children, this is the actual picture of the Shivneri fort. Now here you can see the Mahadarwaza, that is the main door of the fort. This also is the actual picture. Now here, on 19th February 1630, Jijabai gave birth to a son. All the people of the fort were overjoyed. So the child that you can see there is Shivaji. On the 12th day, with appropriate ceremony, the child was named Shivaji, as the child was born on Fort Shivneri. In Shivaji's early childhood, Jijabai did not neglect his education. The child you can see here is Shivaji. And Shivaji's mother Jijabai is in the yellowish sari. Every evening, she would light the house lamps and then call Shivaji to her. She would shower all her affection on him. She would tell him stories of Rama and Krishna, of Bhim and Abhimanyu. Children, you can see all those images in the slide. Krishna, Abhimanyu, Rama and Bhim. She would also recite to him the devotional songs of Namdev, Dhyaneshwar and Eknath. Now children, in this slide you can see on the right hand side, Sant Dhyaneshwar, Sant Namdev and Sant Eknath. Shivaji liked to listen to the exploits of brave men. Shivaji felt that on growing up, he should also display valor like them. Now children, here Shivaji has grown little big, okay, and he is playing with his friends. And children from poor families came to play with Shivaji. Sometimes Shivaji visited their homes, that is their huts, and shared their simple meal of onion and bakri. Now children, they were poor children. Okay, so they would eat simple food and Shivaji would go to their hut and enjoy the simple food. They invented interesting games to pass their time. The children of the Mavlas were like birds in the forest. They would imitate the sound of the cuckoo or parrot or tiger to perfection. Their pastime was building small forts of earth and making earthen elephants and horses. They played hide and seek or played with a ball or a top. Shivaji joined them in all these games and became popular with them. Shahaji Raje returned to Nizamshahi, but he did not get any peace of mind there. Now, children, you can see in this slide, the person on the right hand side in purple clothes, he is Nizam Shah. And on the left hand side in the reddish clothes, he is Shahaji Raje. Now, Nizam Shah believed all the gossip that would go on in the court. Now, this also led to the killing of Lakhuji Rao Jadhav in the court of Nizam Shah. Now, children, on the right hand side, you can see a man in yellow clothes. He is Lakhuji Rao Jadhav. Now, Shahaji Raje, he could not withstand this and he left Nizamshahi and joined the Mughals. Now, children, you can see here on the right hand side in yellow clothes, he is the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan. On the left hand side, in yellow clothes, he is the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan. Okay, and on the right hand side, that is Shahaji Raje. So, the Mughal Emperor made Shahaji Raje a Sardar at his court. Now, children, after this time, Fateh Khan killed Nizam Shah. And he wanted to allow the Mughals to take over the Nizamshahi kingdom. And in return, the Mughals awarded him with the territory under the control of Shahaji Raje. Now, Shahaji Raje was very angry with this and so he left the services of the Mughals and wanted to start a new Nizamshahi kingdom. So, Shahaji Raje found out a small child who was a relative from the Nizam's family. Now, children, here you can see in this slide, that is that small child who is sitting on the throne, whom Shahaji Raje found out about him. And on the fort of Premgiri near Junar, he declared him as the new Nizam Shah. And so he thus established an altogether new kingdom. Shahaji Raje fought bravely to protect this new state. Now, in the beginning, Adil Shah was helping Shahaji Raje in his efforts. But later on, the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan threatened Adil Shah not to help Shahaji Raje. And Adil Shah then signed a treaty of friendship with the Mughal Emperor against Shahaji Raje. So now, children, here you can see in this slide. Okay, now this is called as guerrilla tactics. Now I will explain to you what is guerrilla tactics. Now Shahaji Raje now began to fight the joint forces of the Mughals and Adil Shah using guerrilla tactics. Now what is the meaning of this? Now they would hide among the trees and suddenly attack the enemy with surprise. So the enemy would not know that these people are hiding behind the trees. And then suddenly they would attack the enemy. But Shahaji Raje could not sustain the war all by himself. And in 1636, unwillingly, he signed a treaty of peace with the Mughals. He could not create his own kingdom as the times were not favorable for him. But children, his daring spirit kindled a confidence among the Marathi people. This proved useful for Shivaji in establishing Swaraj a few years later. Now, after the downfall of the Nizam Shahi, which was established by Shahaji Raje, its territories were divided by the Mughals and Adil Shah among themselves. Shahaji Raje's Jagir of Pune and Supe was within Adil Shah's share, but he gave it back to Shahaji Raje. So Shahaji Raje joined the Adil Shahi services. Now children, here you can see on the right hand side is Adil Shah and on the left hand side is Shahaji Raje. Adil Shah gave Shahaji Raje the task of conquering the territories in distant Karnataka, which was far away from Pune. Okay, now children, Shahaji Raje was not with the family for quite some time. Okay, because he was fighting against the enemies in Karnataka. Then later on, Jijabai and Shivaji joined him there. Okay, after some time. Shahaji Raje defeated many kings in Karnataka. So Adil Shah awarded him with the Jagir of Bangalore. Shahaji Raje then made the city of Bangalore his headquarters. He lived there like a king and began to summon the court. Now children, I hope you enjoyed this lesson about Shivaji's childhood. Thank you, children.